Hi, I'm Father Simon Lau. Today, the Church celebrates Pentecost, the descent of the Holy Spirit, also the birth of the Church. It also tells us that human going to enter into a new era. Here, we have two things need to be clear. The Holy Spirit in us and baptism by the Holy Spirit, which is filled with Holy Spirit. In the beginning, when God created the world, the Holy Spirit is in everything so that everything becomes alive and in order. And the Holy Spirit also sustaining us until now. When God created human, He also blew a breath into human. And because of that, human became the only creature has a spirit. And this breath of God is the Holy Spirit. However, the descent of the Holy Spirit is an experience that the disciples receive on Pentecost Day. They experience the Spirit in a special way, filled with their life. They suddenly spoke in different languages and they were given different kind of gifts. When John the Baptist at the river of Jordan, he told the people that I am baptizing you by water, but the one who is to come will baptize you with fire and the Holy Spirit. Baptized with the Holy Spirit. And this is what the disciple experienced. Jesus promised us that He will give the Holy Spirit for those who believe in Him. Or more precisely, the Holy Spirit is to be given to the disciples. I have already explained what is the difference of devotee and disciples. As we look at the past 2 weeks' gospel, which is on John chapter 14 to 17, when Jesus told the disciples before He was crucified, He said, "If you love Me, you will keep My word. If you keep My word, I will ask the Father. He will send the Advocate, the Spirit of truth, and He will teach you everything that I have said to you." And when Jesus prayed to the Father, He said, "I'm praying for these people that You have given to Me. I'm not praying for others." Listen carefully. Jesus is only praying for His disciples, those that God has chosen and given to Jesus. And who are these people? Are you one of them? Jesus was praying for those people who are willing to respond to God's call, who are willing to become His disciple. I don't know, do you ever thought about why Jesus promised us for the Holy Spirit? And He wants us to be filled with the Spirit. God gives us His Spirit. It's not for us to bungkus and keep at home. He gives us His Spirit. It's for us to build His kingdom. And He wants us to carry out the mission that He has given to us. Before He was taken up to heaven, He told the disciples, "Go, make disciples of all nations and baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teach them to observe all the commands that I have given to you." And because of this reason, when the Spirit comes, He will give us all the gifts that we need to build His kingdom and His church. In today's gospel, when Jesus met the disciples, He breathed to them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. For those whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven. And for those whose sins you retain, they are retained." And Jesus breathed to us the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of recreate, the Spirit of rebuild, and the Spirit of restore. To recreate the world and to rebuild our dignity and restore our relationship. Besides, the Holy Spirit was given to us to purify us and sanctify us so that we may be able to live out and learn what is true love. As Jesus commanded us, love one another as I have loved you. That day, there was a person who asked me a question after she watched one of my videos. She said, Father, how to empty ourselves and reject our self-centeredness? It was because in that video, I said, we need to empty ourselves to allow the Holy Spirit to take over our life. So I told her to reject our self-centeredness and to empty ourselves is to reject the three temptations that the devil offers to us. I can do, I want to have, and how people say about me. And these are the four selves that we keep building in our life. For example, very often when we have gathering, usually there are many people do not willing to lead the prayer or in charge of something for the community, to share the word of God or some other things. That is because we are afraid that we are not able to do it well. Doing. And also, we do not know how people will see us. We do not want people to judge us. And this is exactly the second one. How people say about me. And also, we do not want to lose our control. We do not want to lose face. We want to in control. We want to have. To have. We always build and secure ourselves on these three things. To be emptied and reject our self-centeredness is to let go these three things. This including all the decisions and choices that we make every day. Just think of it. Each time our actions and how we decide things is based on these three motives. Only pure love is true. True love enables us to overcome all this. True love is self-emptiness, allowing the Holy Spirit to take charge of our life. Normally, the parents' love for their children is pure and not selfish. Because of love, we can sacrifice everything for our children. We can become vulnerable for our children. And even we do not bother how people look at us. Sometimes we do crazy things because of love for our children. It is because we just love them. True love enables us to let go all these things. And true love enables us to experience the true freedom within and have courage to face all the challenges in life. However, those who do not love and do not have God in their life, they will become more self-centered and selfish and also keep building up their false self, and their life will be full of worries, anxiety and fear. St. Paul said, all the gifts of the Holy Spirit is for our good, and all the gifts are given to us to build His kingdom and the church. When Paul finished explaining the gifts of the Holy Spirit, he continued with love. At 1 Corinthians chapter 13, he said, if I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a cymbal crushing. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are and knowing everything, if I have faith in all its fullness to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Paul then said, love does not come to an end, but if there are gifts of prophecy, the time will come when they must fail, or the gift of languages, it will not continue forever. And knowledge for these two, the time will come when it must fail. Love is no end. Love is our purpose, and love is why the Spirit is given to us. Brothers and sisters, do your life filled with the Holy Spirit? Do you allow the Spirit works in your life? Do you willing to empty yourself, reject all these false self and the temptation given by the devil? We need to allow the Holy Spirit to purify us and sanctify us. The Holy Spirit wants to teach us how to love. He wants us to be the disciple, because God is love, and this love will lead us to eternal life. May the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, His gifts, His grace, His life to all the disciples of Christ, to recreate, rebuild, restore, and to be sanctified and purified. Amen. Hallelujah.